2 days before pouring concrete into the foundation, there was heavy rainstorm in the area, causing 2 sections of the foundation to cave in. Luckily, I got the stop. If I didn't get it, it could have got a lot worse, and also I could have done a better job laying it out. One corner section, the entire underneath of the dirt kind of collapsed. After taking out all the dirt, I use a spray foam to put some cushion between the sewage pipe and the concrete. The concrete and the sewage pipe should not be in direct contact with each other. I use it on both sides of the foundation because the sewage pipe runs directly under the whole slab. Then we apply a 6 mm moisture barrier on top of the gravel. Then we're gonna use number 3 rebar on top of it. I made this jig that allow us to bend the rebar. It's just a piece of lumber and some screw to hold the rebar while we're bending it. This is what the layout of the rebar look like. There are also 2 rows of rebar going in the entire footing of this foundation. On Monday, the concrete truck came right on time. S&L Material, located in Pennsauken, New Jersey. They had the best price in the area, and they are the only type of company with this type of truck. They mix the concrete on site. Unlike the traditional concrete truck, you pay for exactly what you buy since there are no wasted material. The first truck poured down 11 yards of concrete into the foundation. Once the second truck got here, we got right back to work. As we were getting closer to finishing this concrete job, I was getting excited. This is my first time pouring down the concrete. Even the driver helped us out because it looked like they have a lot of experience with concrete. The second truck poured 3 yards of concrete, bringing it to a total of 14 yards of concrete, which is exactly what I estimate. Just before the concrete truck got to the house, I made the DIY bow flow out of some scrap lumber that I had. They are really straight, and I think it did a good job for what I needed. So you're probably wondering how much the concrete costs in my area. So I live in New Jersey, and for 14 yards of concrete from this company, it cost me a total of $2,663.70. That's tax included and everything. I call multiple concrete company in my area for the same quote of 14 yards. All of them would be over $3,000. So this concrete company was the best price in my area. I know concrete price fluctuate a lot based on where you live. Let me know in the comment below, with delivery tax and everything, how much 14 yards of concrete would cost you. Just before the concrete got too hard, I installed 18 galvanized exterior anchor bolt, size 1/2 inch by 9/21/25 inch. Then all the extra dirt that came from this footing was spread out to the lowest part of the yard. Then I kept working the slab with a trowel. My phone ran out of battery, but I was able to use 2 foam boards to work the center of the concrete slab. This is what the slab looked like before it fully cured. And this is what it looks like a couple of days after. It's been raining. That was really good. Overall, I am really happy with how this concrete footing came out, and I think it's pretty straight. This is the first time I did this type of work. Thank you very much for coming to my channel. Have a good one.